them to breakfast.
You know what the worst food to eat on camera is? A banana.
Success, Cristen, you all had a lot to say about the question of why do women lie about sex, which really was a question of why are you assuming, gentlemen, that women are lying about sex. Mickey B14 said, I think that since nowadays sexual imagery and sexuality has become so commonplace, people sometimes forget how intimate an act sex can be. Some women enjoy casual sex more, and that's totally fine if that's what they're comfortable with, but assuming that all women want that or are down for that at all times is not okay. Not just women, everybody is gonna have different kinds of sexual preferences. If you want the best possible sex, make it the most enthusiastically consensual sex. Case and Doyle also offered this observation, which kind of blew my mind in how true it is. Sex and food are two of the most wonderful things in the world, and society tries to shame women out of both. Shame on you, society. I want pizza, and I want amazing sex, and I don't want to hear anything about it, society. Finally, Lily Dabke says, I have a dream that one day men and women can both decline sex and not have their motives questioned, where people can be a virgin for life and not have people look down on them, where slut shaming doesn't exist, yet neither does a standard where a man must sleep with many women to be more manly. A world where sexual preference and desires are not questioned. Let's remember, guys and gals, C is for consent, and unless someone is sober and says yes, that is not okay. Legally, you can't be drunk and give consent. Now for this week's Ask Cristen question, which is coming from a YouTube commenter name that I'm probably gonna mispronounce, Darajat. Could you make a video on why women find more stuff to be disgusted about than men? Is it just because we are more open about being disgusted by stuff and men wanna hide it? Believe it or not, there is actually a lot of scientific research on this very question. The idea is that humans are evolutionarily inclined to be disgusted by certain things because it was a useful mechanism to help us avoid dangerous pathogens way back in the day. Darjat, your hunch that women say ew more often is usually supported by studies looking at gender differences and disgust sensitivity, which typically find that women tend to have a more heightened disgust sensitivity compared to men. When you start looking at the broader body of research on disgust sensitivity, it's not necessarily a hard and fast rule that women are gonna be like, ugh, by everything, and guys are gonna be like, whoa, that's no big deal. First of all, because we probably all know a guy who might get kind of squeamish at the sight of blood. For another example, plenty of women working in gory places like emergency rooms. There's also a study in 2010 taking a deeper look at sex differences in disgust sensitivity. They found, quote, a small sex difference in sensitivity to pathogen and moral disgust, and a large sex difference in sensitivity to sexual disgust. This is interesting. With women more sensitive to disgust across all domains, they concluded that overall, these findings suggest that despite mean or average sex differences in disgust sensitivity, there are similar constructs in men and women. In other words, on the whole, men and women are more alike in their ew factor than they are different. Another interesting finding that jumped out to me was a study from January of this year that found a correlation between heightened disgust sensitivity and conservatism in women. Also replicated in other studies which have found a link between heightened disgust sensitivity in people, men and women alike, and political and social conservatism. There was even one study which found a relationship between people's heightened disgust sensitivity and opposition to same-sex marriage. Could we open people's minds to more progressive viewpoints if we just expose them to like rotting food and make them somehow inured to like the sight of blood? One thing that I didn't find in research that I am curious about in your question is whether or not there is a socialization factor to this, whether men specifically are more prone to hide their disgust so as to not seem unmanly. Speaking though of differences in men and women's disgust sensitivity, last night Professor Boyfriend and I were jogging together and we passed by this cat that had gotten hit by a car and its guts were everywhere, and I was like, oh, when we passed by it. It was like he didn't even see it. And unfortunately, that mutilated cat was the first thing that came to my mind when I read your question. But what do you think? Are girls and women legitimately more easily grossed out than guys, or are guys just better at hiding it? And don't forget to ask me your questions for next week. What should I talk about? What questions are on your mind? What can I offer some insight into? See you next week.